There's that! Dude, that was such a clean counter!
We're going to be talking about the block jump skill for Kunoa and Ninja and how to counter it as a striker. Now, the first thing that you need to be able to do is identify the skill, what it looks like. And the second thing that you need to do is understand what the skill is used for. We're not going to go too in-depth with this because this is just a quick little tips video. But what this skill is, in a nutshell, it is a bread and butter skill for both classes, Kunoa and Ninja. It is one of their main engages to close the gap in order to set up grab plays or any other play. But normally it's used to close the gap into a grab. So we're gonna take a look at this skill right here. You could use it on your hotbar. I'm on my ninja class right now. Right when I use it, you're gonna see a little poof and you're gonna see a little log come out. Little log animation come out. It's really, really telegraphed, and you can distinguish it from any other skill in the game. You just have to be paying attention. The other thing to note is that after you use this skill, the ninja or Kunoa can either teleport to your backside or to your front side, either or. And the last thing that you have to understand with this skill is that when you use it, or when they use it rather, they have the option to stay in what's pretty much just God mode right here for 2 to 3 seconds. And in that 2 to 3 second window, they could teleport to you or cancel it. So they could either teleport to your backside, your front side, or cancel it altogether by just either not doing anything or hitting S, and it's just going to take them out of it. So that's the basic function and the basic mechanics of the skill. Most players are going to be doing block jump to grab, just like this. Yep. And that is what you're looking out for. You're always looking out for the log animation that pops up when they use the skill. Okay, so we're back on our striker here. Try this. Backstep here to twisted collision. And it looks like this. Now, backstep is an iframe. You don't have to worry about the magic DP buff and the movement speed buff. It's not relevant in this case, but it's an iframe. And then twisted collision is our fastest insta CC that we have. And you actually have a little bit of range with it. So you can see I'm clearly not directly in front of the target. I can hit twisted and it will actually float. So there is a little cushion there, and that's important because you don't exactly know where the server is going to register the ninja to be after the block jump, whether it's in front of you or behind you. And with desync involved, it's just you need a little bit of range. So let's say we're fighting here and the target gets to my backside here by block jump. Let's just say that's the ninja. It's a simple backstep to twisted for the counter. Okay, so we're going to go back to the clip that's played in the beginning of this video here. And please do excuse the quality, considering I play on a potato. This is from a VOD from my Twitch stream. So the quality gets... I think it gets like downgraded a little bit, and I don't really stream with high FPS to begin with, so please do excuse that. So if we look at this skirmish here, you're gonna see I use a rage hammer there. I'm cycling through my super armors is essentially all it is. I'm doing that because I have space. Rage hammer is a little bit dangerous if I'm using it against a good Kunoa and a good ninja. Because I get locked into the animation of Rage Hammer for a little while. I mean, obviously it's not like 8 seconds where I'm just locked in there, but these quick iframey classes can really engage very, very quick, and it can be dangerous to use that. So I have space, so I'm able to use it. I'm just cycling super armors. I'm gonna follow that up with a mass destruction as he's clearly closed the gap. And there's the log right there that I see. Now he's got about that 2 to 3 second window frame. And you're going to see me cancel my mass destruction. I think I'm going to hit twice. There's one, two, and then there's the back step. So I've done a mass destruction, cancel into back step. You're going to see him appear right where my character is right here. There he is on my backside. And then I'm going to follow that up with that backstep to twisted collision counter. And you can see here the range is pretty ridiculous. This is probably about maximum range with the twisted. And you're just going to see that land. I follow that up with a Nimbus because I have the AP to follow the float up with a Nimbus and go straight into Skullcrusher and finish the fight there. I would suggest, my personal recommendation in that fight, if you don't have the AP, I wouldn't go to Nimbus because I believe the Nimbus is going to actually eat up the second CC. Or you can Nimbus like away, but I would just do like a flash step towards him into another grab to get maximum damage out of it. I didn't need to do that simply because I was able to kill him with my AP with just that single float. So if we take a look at it again, you're going to see me go Rage Hammer, Mass Destruction. Again, Rage Hammer, Mass Destruction is just me cycling my Super Armors. I see the log. I delay my backstep by about a second. I cancel my Mass Destruction before the kick part hits. I backstep into Twisted, and you see I catch him with the Twisted for the float. Right there. And then... That's GG.